My name is Erin Reynolds. I'm the COPS for Cancer coordinator from the Canadian Cancer Society in Prince George. Tour to North has been rolling for 16 years this year. I would say on an average year, we are making around $300,000. The money goes to pediatric cancer research and Camp Good Times. Oh, this has been a challenging year. Absolutely. We've had wildfires. We've had members not able to join us because of the wildfire duties they've had. We've had members and team members from all over the region making other fundraisers happen that have tried to compensate, but we have noticed a difference to the fundraising for sure. In Chetwynd, Dawson Creek, and Fort St. John, the Jail and Bails have been excellent. We had Chetwynd raising $16,000. We had Dawson Creek raising, I think, $17,000. Is that correct? And we had Fort St. John coming in at $22,000. It's great. Oh, of course I'm happy. I'm happy that when you put the wildfires aside, the Tour to North rises up as a priority to people because they care about kids.
So my name is Constable Brody Garrison, and I'm out of McKenzie RCMP Detachment, and I am the team lead for Tour de North this year, and I drive the lead support vehicle, which is a marked police vehicle. The challenge of being the team leader for Tour de North, I would have to say, is getting everything coordinated and running smoothly. We have quite a few riders and some other support personnel as well, so trying to coordinate everyone to get ready for the rides in the morning, what we have to do when we arrive to our destination, and then everything in between as we're riding during the day, making sure that everyone has all of their supplies, water, food, everything like that, coordinating our rest stops, where our rest stops are going to be, and then of course making sure that the peloton, as it travels down the road, everyone is safe. All traffic is being managed, and the safety of the peloton is the big thing. So this year has been a fantastic year for the Tour de North, traveling down the road. We've had fantastic weather. We've had nothing but sunshine so far, which is a great benefit to us, as the visibility for the drivers to see us on the roadway with our lights and the peloton's bright jerseys and that makes it a lot safer for us, and also having dry roadways so the peloton can travel down the roadway with ease. So this year has been fantastic for traveling down the roadways, and the traffic in general has been very courteous and patient with the peloton traveling down the road.
Hello, my name is Trent Ernst. I'm a second year COPS for Cancer rider. I am not a cop though, I am the media rider. My daughter Zoe, when she was 6 years old, she actually suffered from ovarian cancer. It was a very traumatic experience, a very trying experience. Having gone through it myself, I want to do what I can to help other people, other parents who have to go through it, to experience the best outcomes possible. It's getting better, right? In the 1960s, the survival rates for kids with cancer was 0%. Nowadays, it's actually upwards of about 80%. But we need to figure out those last 20%. The most common forms of childhood cancer are things like leukemia. Thank you. Sorry. The most common form of childhood cancer is leukemia, and the amount of research that's gone into that is incredible. But some of the more rare forms of cancer, things like brain cancers, survival rates are still atrocious there. So there still needs to be research done in those areas. The treatments that a lot of these kids have to go through are the same treatments that adults have to go through. And something that is hard on an adult body can be devastating to a kid's body. You know, there's kids that, you know, some of these drugs can like completely stunt the kid's growth. We've come a long way in the last 50 years, but we still have a long ways to go.
Hello, my name's Zoe Mashansky. I'm a paramedic from Dawson Creek, and I represent BC Ambulance on the Tour de North. It's been an incredible year. This is my first year on the tour, so we started off in Williams Lake, and we're working our way back to Dawson Creek via Hudson's Hope. And we've been really fortunate, great weather, and so can't complain. It's been an amazing opportunity, especially in each town we get to meet all the kids that we've influenced or that we get a chance to help out. Through the Dawson Creek jail and bail, it was a cumulative effort. We had the Dawson Creek RCMP as well as tons of local help. I do believe we raised about $17,000 in that, so we're pretty excited and we're just happy to see where it goes. So, of course, I would love to do it again. It's an amazing cause and opportunity just to help support everyone and all those affected by cancer.
My name is Constable Boychuk. I'm from Fort St. John. I've been up there for 8 years with the RCMP, and that is my first posting. And this is my first ride here with the Tour de North. Me and my partner in Fort St. John, who's also riding, Constable Williams, and together we did a jail and bail, and we raised a total of $22,157 in our jail and bail. So hugely successful. We were pretty happy with that. And then we also did fill the boot. So we were in our surge. We stood in front of Save-On Foods, and we had one of the brown high browns. And we filled that up right to the top, and with that we raised, I don't know the exact number, but a little over $1,500. And then I raised a little bit on my own through my page, which was $534.
My name's Tristan Williams, from Fort St. John, British Columbia, part of the RCMP there. And the reason I decided to join Cancer has had a profound effect on my family. My grandmother had cancer, my grandfather had cancer, and actually just this February I lost my aunt to cancer, unfortunately. Not only that, but I have a daughter, a 2.5-year-old daughter. My wife is 8 months pregnant with our second child, and thankfully my daughter is healthy, but you know, I'm doing this on the off chance that she ever does get sick, and for all the kids that are sick, it's such an amazing cause. And you know, 80% goes to research, 20% goes to Camp Good Times, and what an amazing, amazing cause. So it was a no-brainer. It's something I had to do. It's been very difficult. Yeah, it's tough. You're supposed to do 1,500 kilometers of training beforehand, and then it's another 840, essentially, between Williams Lake and Dawson. Our longest day so far was 190 kilometers, but anytime I'm you know, I'm doing it, and I think it's tough where I'm getting tired. I just think, hey, I'm healthy. This is nothing. People are dealing with cancer. I can do this. This is the least I can do to help out, right? So.
Hi, I'm with Chase Kiryata and his grandpa, Mel. And has this day been a big day for you, Chase?
I don't know.
What did you do as a junior rider with Cops for Cancer?
I biked.
And where did you bike from?
The Welcome to Chetwin sign.
Okay, and can you tell me a little bit about Cops for Cancer? You went to a camp, right?
Yeah.
And did you like the camp?
Yeah.
And what did you do at the camp?
I kayaked.
Pardon?
I kayaked.
You kayaked, and did you have a lot of fun?
Yeah.
Okay, so today is a big day. You rode with all the police for Cops for Cancer,
mm-hmm.
And can you give us a little thank you to Chetwin for everyone who has supported Cops for Cancer?
Thank you.
Okay, very good, Chase. Congratulations. You've been a junior rider for 2 years, right?
Yeah.
Super. Thank you.
I'm not too sure how many people here are new that weren't here earlier for the photo op, but this...
I wasn't.
Oh, right, Trent, you were missing. Just a big thank you to Chetwin community and all the people, members of almost every emergency services there is in Chetwin that came out to escort us into town today, that believe in what we're doing, that follow along with Tour de North that know Chase, know Zoe, and have been there to support Donna and Mel, and they in turn are putting their efforts into helping us with our event. Thank you so much.
Yay!
Continue.
Sorry.
So that's the way to do it, though. Very good. We've met junior team members in other communities besides this one. In Williams Lake, we met Chase, or the team all got to meet him as well as myself. We've had two junior team members in Prince George, Hannah and Audrey, and they're pretty great little girls that are growing up and doing everything that children are supposed to be doing. And Camp Good Times is an awesome place that we are putting some of our funds that we've raised here with this tour and with the other three tours in the province. I hope everyone here knows in the community that Mel and Donna and Chase and Crystal went and had a fabulous time, and there's a photo album that Donna worked really hard to put together for us. If you haven't had a chance to see that, that's pretty cool. Camp Good Times is fully medically supported, and it's completely free for families anywhere in British Columbia, Yukon, to attend if they've gone through cancer. It's a chance for them to experience just being a kid again for 4 or 5 days, and to see other people and family members, siblings that have gone through what they've gone through. You don't know what it's like until you go through it, no matter how much empathy you have for people. So Camp Good Times is really precious, and if you ever get a chance to go and visit it, it's in the first 6 weeks of the summer down in Maple Ridge, and there are some pretty strict guidelines from a medical perspective to make sure you have your vaccinations, because we're protecting an immune compromised population there. But it is such a cool place and such happy people there. I went once, and you think you're going there to cheer people up, and they actually are, they don't need cheering up. They're there and they're living life. So it's quite an honor to be able to see what has been created there. And that camp's been going for about 30 years because of the Canadian Cancer Society and because of people like you. So thank you so much.
Can I cheer now?
Yeah.
Yay! Yay!